Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. With no standard SpaceX updates, we are kicking off this video with a view of the whole orbital launch site as construction progresses. The boom of the crane for stacking the integration tower was recently lowered. Engineers continue to work on the beams between the orbital launch mount legs. Work on the unknown structure at the propellant production site has been continuing. Work continues on the orbital launch table still in the production yard. Here's a view of a barrel section spotted being worked on inside a tent. Currently, there are many barrel sections sitting outside in the production yard. Jonathan McDowell posted a tweet saying, "I took a look at what's known for the proposed marginal orbit trajectory for the Starship Super Heavy test flight. I came up with an okay fit with an orbit that is about 70 by 860 kilometers by 26.4 degrees. The relatively high apogee is needed to accommodate a low perigee in the range to HI. Scott Manley responded with, "This is assuming no deorbit burn and limited aerodynamic effects." Then Jonathan McDowell said, "Exactly, and by limited I mean zero. Aerodynamic effects are too difficult for me." Finally, Musk responded with, "LD makes quite a big difference. We do care about lift for Starship much more than Dragon, as lower peak heating is needed for reusability of heat shield. Dragon prefers high peak, low total heat load as it is driven by tile heat pulse reaching bond line while under parachutes." Somebody posted a cool diagram of the production progress for different Raptor engines. Marcus House tweeted about it with the caption, "Awesome detail being tracked here by Artzius. Would indeed be interesting to know if Raptor Boost is still targeting a thrust around 300 plus metric tons. Musk responded and said, "Current plan is to increase base Raptor thrust to approximately 230 tons or approximately 500 million pounds and increase booster engine count to 32 or 33. In response to that tweet, Musk was asked, "How is Raptor Vac development going? Getting closer to the aspirational 382nd ISP or holding at 350 seconds. Elon Musk responded with, "Looking good at approximately 378 seconds. Continued improvement will get it over 380. In response to that Raptor thrust tweet, Musk also posted another saying, "All Raptors on booster, whether fixed or gimbaling, would be the same. 33 by 230 gets approximately 7600 tons of thrust and thrust to weight ratio of approximately 1.5. Jack Beyer responded to that asking, "What's the point of an R-boost if it gets the same thrust as a standard Raptor? Weight reduction?" Musk responded with, "Center engines on ship will be same as booster engines. This is basically Raptor 2. Raptor vacuum would be only variant. To be determined as to whether to commonize RVAC with Raptor 2, more thrust, keep same, or tighten throat, more ISP. Adding 3 more RVAC to ship with max ISP maybe." Then somebody responded to that tweet asking, "Wait, what? Your team is considering upping the number of Raptor VACs on Starship, the upper stage, not the full stack, from 3 to 6? Or did I misunderstand your tweet?" Musk responded to that with, "It's one possibility. The GSC3 tank was recently moved in the yard. As we saw last episode, Booster 3 is now on suborbital pad A, looking absolutely incredible. Engineers are working on the prototype to prepare it for upcoming testing. The crane has since been unhooked from the booster. I want to share the Rodent Beach closures on the Cameron County website. Whilst I'm not sure, I would guess these closures are for super heavy Booster 3 testing. Currently, there is a closure scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 8th, and Friday this week, as well as possibly Monday next week, July 12th. This super heavy Booster 4 section was seen moving near tents. As always, thanks once again to Mary or Boca Chica Girl, who is out in Boca Chica filming the content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.